What is going on, everyone? Hope all is well. I'm actually in the midst of fixing my camera right now. If you don't see anything, there we go. Still fixing it a little bit more. And there we go. All right, so I hope everybody has had a great day. I'm actually proud of myself. I made it right on time, literally. So today is Fun Friday. I think I'll wait until Robert get on here before I find his. So what I'll do is start with some Chappelle. My hand hurts really bad. Well, not really bad. That's exaggerating. It just hurts a little bit. It's all good. It's all gravy. I hope y'all having an amazing Friday. I know good and well I did that. I probably did it on something else. What's going on, Toad? How you feeling? To it. No ads. Right. I can't complain. I cannot complain. I did take a nap, so I'm still waking up. Had to wake up super early. Get to the crib and I'm like, what is it? What it was. I had to wake up super early, get to the crib, and then took a nap so I could be energized. And it takes me like forever to wake up. Now tell me about Ice JJ Fish on the floor. What is that about? What is that about? Is it funny? Is it food?
Yo, Tanisha, it was good.
What is it? Excuse me. What is going on? We are about to get into Keeping It Real Can Go Very Wrong. Chappelle Show. Let's check it out. We know this is about to be crazy.
Yo, Tanisha, it was good seeing you.
Darius heard the comment and had a simple choice to make. Ignore what the man had said and take Tanisha home, or stay at the party and keep it real. When keeping it real goes wrong.
Okay, Robert, put your request in here. I know it's in my Patreon, but just put it in here for me. We can do it next.
So I'm Dave, and I keep it real. Sometimes keeping it real can go horribly wrong. We got to pick our spots. It's good to be real sometimes. It's good to be phony sometimes. Yes, I said it. Phony. Think I'm this nice in real life? F*** that, son. It's because I'm on TV. I'm wild. I pull my balls out right now. I don't care. Skeet, 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 skeet.
Lil John.
If you don't believe me that keeping it real ain't the best thing, then take a look at this.
Uh-oh.
Vernon Franklin was an exceptional young man. He was the valedictorian of his high school class, won several scholarships, and became the first person in his family to attend college. He got a good job and worked 14-hour days, 6 days a week, quickly becoming the youngest vice president in the history of the Viacorp Corporation, ending the cycle of violence and drug addiction that had plagued his family for generations. The officers of his company were wrapping up the usual Thursday meeting in the South Conference Room when Frank Murphy, the man who had mentored Vernon, made an awkward comment.
Vernon, great job, buddy. You the man. Give me some skin, huh?
Vernon got along with all of the people he worked with, which in his heart of hearts made him feel like an Uncle Tom. Though he could have ignored the simple comment his mentor made, Vernon decided to keep it real.
Get your motherfucking hand out of my face. You heard me, mother. Get your hands out of my face. What you think this is, man? Just shake my hand like a man. I gotta give you some five on the backhand side with all this crazy jab. That's bull. You want a little soft shoe? Should I juggle some watermelon for you, boy? All that,
man. Hey, Vernon, buddy.
Get your motherfucking hands off me, boy. Play the game.
Even the Vernon I know.
Allow me to reintroduce myself. My name is Ho. You've heard that before, Ho. Dangerous. I used to beat motherfuckers up just like you. Just for walking around my way, nigga.
Vernon, buddy.
You better sit down, Frank. I said, sit down, bitch. Thug like, that is a game, nigga. Ow, ow, ow. Okay.
Today, Vernon works at Sonny's Filler up on Route 80 in New Jersey. He makes $6.45.
This is hilarious.
An hour and stinks of gasoline, even when he's not at the station. It's as real as it can be.
Dollar? What am I gonna get with a dollar? Nigga, I got kids. And that's real.
Vernon Franklin. Once a heartwarming story of perseverance.
Wu-Tang!
Today, a sparkling example of when keeping it real goes wrong.
People say it to me all the time, Dave, you got that show? But remember, brother, keep it real. Very good advice. Not always as easy as it seems. Sometimes, folks, keeping it real works against you.
Yes, sir.
Darius James was out on a date with his girlfriend, Tanisha Bradley. Darius was almost certain the night would end with sex. But as they were leaving, confrontation reared its ugly head.
Yo, Tanisha, it was good seeing you.
Darius heard the comment and had a simple choice to make. Ignore what the man had said and take Tanisha home, or stay at the party and keep it real.
What'd you say, man?
Good seeing.
Good seeing? I don't play that. That's my girl, nigga. I keep it real.
What Darius didn't know is that Chris was a 10th degree black belt who started trouble just so he could practice his karate and street fighting scenarios. What ensued was one of the most spectacular ass whoopings ever witnessed in the Atlantic Northeast. Viewer discretion is advised. Darius lost four of his teeth, fractured his arm, spine, and pelvis, and then Tanisha got involved.
All his talk about keeping it real was getting on my last nerves. I savored that ass whooping.
Kick him in the ass.
The tag team ass whooping continued for minutes. Ending when karate expert Chris left with Tanisha. That night, they had sex three times. As a result of his hospital bills, Darius was forced to move back in with his grandma.
This knucklehead talking about keeping it real.
Oh my gosh, this is too much.
I'm gonna keep it real. I want his goddamn ass out of my house. I'm trying to get my swerve on too.
Darius is humiliated on a daily basis.
Ready, don't?
Well, hurry the hell up and finish yourself off there.
Unlike you, I'm getting a little action tonight, you punk bitch.
He is witness to things that no man should ever have to see.
Darius, you big dummy, this ain't no show and tell. Take a walk.
Yeah, get some rubbers.
And get the big ones.
Right.
From most assuredly having sex with his girl to getting beat up and moving back with his family.
Granny, don't!
Darius James showed us what can happen when keeping it real goes wrong.
We all just gotta be careful. When you're keeping it real, pick your spots. Reality is hidden for a reason. And now we will show you why.
Brenda Johnson was at home one night eating popcorn and watching television with her girlfriend. The telephone rang.
Man, what in the world we watching?
Hello.
Brenda had a simple choice to make. Ignore the mild rudeness of someone hanging up on her, or keep it real.
That! I don't like people playing on my phone.
Girl, don't even trip. You bigger than that.
No! I don't like people playing on my phone.
But in reality, it had nothing to do with people playing on her phone. Brenda had long suspected her boyfriend Jamal of cheating on her. This was the straw that broke the camel's back.
Hello?
Did you just call here, bitch?
Excuse me?
I know you just called here. Don't play dumb with me. Stop my man.
I don't know what you're talking about. I dialed the wrong number, okay?
I star 69'd you, you dirty hoe. You and I both know you sleeping with Jamal.
No, I was trying to call my aunt.
Oh, bitch, please. You a bitch, and so is your aunt. Oh, no, she did not hang up on me again.
Again?
Brenda could have ended the conflict there.
You want to play, bitch? Let's play.
But she decided to push her reel-o-meter into the red.
Because I keeps it real like that.
Brenda went onto her computer and did a reverse lookup of Genesis' number.
Man, who in here ever been a stalker, no judgment, or has had a stalker in a relationship type deal? What's going on, TC? What's going on? It's a KHE. What's up, y'all?
Not only did she get Genesis' address, but directions as well.
I'm fitting to ride on this bitch. Won't be Jamal in this car, ho. Take that, you clap-having Jezebel! It was a wrong number! That! I don't like people playing on my phone! I keep it real!
What Brenda didn't know is that Janice was borrowing the car from her older brother, a federal agent. She also didn't know that defacing a government vehicle is considered a felony in certain cases, this being one of them. After a short trial, Brenda was sentenced to 6 years in federal prison.
What's really hood, bitch?
Brenda knew it was important to establish her realness early in prison. Confronted by another pivotal decision, she decided then and there to keep it real.
All right, bitch, let's settle this right now.
The three women were all serving consecutive life sentences. It turned out they kept it realer.
Wow.
And as for her boyfriend Jamal,
you want to talk about keeping it real?
He was cheating on Brenda with her best friend.
I keep it real. Ain't that right, shorty?
That's right.
From eating popcorn in the comfort of her own home to eating fruit cocktail off of a prison floor, Brenda rounds.
That! I don't like people playing on my phone.
Just another case of what can happen when keeping it real goes wrong. Chappelle
Show. Wow, that is ridiculous. I am your girl, V-Coop. Down piece in the V-Coop to be exact. Make sure you like, comment, share, subscribe, all that good stuff, man. Come over to the COOP Troop Live every single day, 2:30 to 4:30 p.m. Eastern time zone, all right? Till next time, thank you for joining. All right, let's get into... Gonna do Quita's request. Let's see here. Chappelle, a fool for real. How's everybody Friday going? Oh, I remember him. I haven't seen this though.
You need the right marketer.
Like, I just know about him from social media. All right, y'all, we're about to get into Ice JJ Fish on the Floor official music video. Let's check it out. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Hey, TC, you think he winning or you beating him? Ooh, ooh. Ooh.
It's something about the girl that just makes my head wanna twirl. Oh, you got me want to tell all them other girls. There's nothing else better on this world.
What the world? Toad. Thinking, man, what's going on?
The moment I seen her, I was in shock.
Toad request is what that is. That's exactly what it is. Karaoke. But a real song instead.
She wants to take it slow. I'm not the type of guy. I'll let you know when I see that real life.
85 million views, bruh. 85 million views.
All I know is girls. So many girls and duties on the floor. She said she wants to take it slow.
If he wrote this, great lyrics, just needed a different singer, that's all. He probably was tired of waiting on a singer.
Yo, I'ma let you know, you're one that I'm really into, boo. Doesn't mean I'm one place I can be, but I'd rather be with you.
The fact that they got her in the video dancing like him is a killer. That's a winner right there.
To throw your life, because baby girl, you're on my mind. She wants to take it slow. I'm not the type of guy. I'll let you know when I see it real life. All I know is girls.
TC, your turn. Kill him. Kill him. Kill him. Kill him. Wow. Oh my gosh. I am your real V-Coop, Dime Piece and V-Coop to be exact. Make sure you like, comment, share, subscribe, all that good stuff, man. Come over to the COOP Troop Live, too, every single day, 2:30 to 4:30 p.m. Eastern Time Zone, all right? Till next time, thank you for joining. The stuff, y'all choose. But Fun Friday is going good so far. This the only day I feel like needs help and getting in the going in the right direction. A-N-K-H-E-N-A-T-E-N. I don't know how to pronounce that. But we're only doing funny stuff today. Just to keep in, just so you can keep that in mind. Where is the video to Weird and Nerdy? Oh, maybe let me take the pressure fuse out. I don't know why it don't work because of that. Oh, no worries. It ain't no big deal.
When it comes,
but you can request that on Tuesdays, 2:30 to 4:30, same time frame on Tuesday. Uh-oh. They got Key and Pill in here. It seems like it's way more than one person on here, but I guess my stream be tripping. What is going on, everyone? We are about to get into Weird Al, White and Nerdy official music video. Let's check it out.
They see me mowing my front lawn. I know they're all thinking I'm so white and nerdy.
Think I'm just too white and nerdy.
Think I'm just too white and nerdy.
Can't you see I'm white and nerdy?
Look at me, I'm white and nerdy.
I wanna roll with
too white and nerdy.
MIT. Got skills, I'm a champion of D&D. MC Escher, that's my favorite MC. Keep your 40 out, just have an Earl Grey tea. My rims never spin, to the contrary, you'll find that they're quite stationary. All of my action figures are cherry. Stephen Hawking's in my library. My MySpace page is all totally pimped out. Got people begging for my top 8 spaces. Yo, I know pie to a thousand places. Ain't got no grills, but I still wear braces. I order all of my sandwiches with mayonnaise. I'm a whiz, a minesweeper, I can play for days. Once you see my sweet moves, you're gonna stay amazed. My fingers moving so fast.
This is wild. And one, I don't even think I realized it was this song. I don't think I paid attention earlier, rapper. What's going on, Cynthia? How you feeling?
I set the place ablaze. There's no killer rap I haven't run. At Pascal, well, I'm number one. Do vector calculus just for fun. I ain't got a gap, but I got a soldering gun. Happy Days is my favorite theme song. I could sure kick your butt in a game of ping pong. I'll ace any trivia quiz you bring on. I'm fluent in JavaScript as well as Klingon.
Fun fact, when I was in college, I played ping pong all the time. Whether I was playing it right or not is none of y'all business.
Roll on my Segway. I know in my heart they think I'm white and nerdy.
Think I'm just too white and nerdy.
Think I'm just too white and nerdy.
Can't you see I'm white and nerdy?
Look at me, I'm white and nerdy.
I like to roll with the gangsters, although it's apparent I'm too white and nerdy.
Think I'm just too white and nerdy.
Think I'm just too white and nerdy.
So white and nerdy.
I've been browsing, inspecting X-Men comics. You know I collect them. The pens in my pocket, I must protect them. My ergonomic keyboard never leaves me bored. Shopping online for deals on some writable media. I edit Wikipedia. I memorize Holy Grail really well. I can recite it right now and have you ROTFLOL. I got a business doing websites.
Let's go, TC. Let's go.
Friends need some code, who do they call? I do HTML for them all. Even made a homepage for my doll. Yo, I got myself a fanny pack. They were having a sale down at the Gap. Spend my nights with a roll of bubble wrap. Pop, pop, hope no one sees me getting freaky.
I'm nerdy and the extreme and whiter than sour cream.
I was in AV club and glee club and even the chess team. Only question I ever thought was hard. What do I like, Kirk, or do I like Picard?
Spend every weekend at the Renaissance Fair. Got my name on my underwear. They see me strolling, they laughing. Roll in their eyes cause I'm so white and nerdy.
because I'm white and nerdy. Just because I'm white and nerdy. All because I'm white and nerdy. Holy cow, I'm white and nerdy. I wanna bowl with the gangsters. But oh well, it's obvious I'm white and nerdy. Think I'm just too white and nerdy. Think I'm just too white and nerdy. I'm just too white and nerdy. Look at me, I'm white and nerdy.
This man is a fool, man. I am your girl, V-Coop. Dime piece in the V-Coop to be exact. Make sure you like, comment, share, subscribe, all that good stuff, man. Come over to the COOP Troop Live, too, every single day, 2:30 to 4:30 p.m. Eastern time zone, all right? Till next time, thank you for joining. All right, TC, we on yours right now. It's going good so far. I'm liking y'all request. Let's see. Okay. I'm interested in this.
I'm making such quick cash doing this.
What is a Donny Osmond? I don't think I know nothing about that.
Hey, yo, when I was saying that nobody could stand on stage with me, I wasn't talking about you.
Nah, say less. This is Nas. We go way back. We already had our beef. We got over it. You know what I'm saying? Now we here. We men. We did the joint with Khaled. Sorry, not sorry.
I'm just so tired of they keep asking me about this versus battle, and I just said what I said at the time, but you know, I would never do that to you.
Oh man, shit. We billionaires, we crypto kings.
But I mean, we here now. Let's just have some fun with it, you know? Let's just go back and forth.
Nah, we doing this for fun. This gonna be fun. This for the people.
Yeah, so my first song, I'ma just hit you with that hard knock life. Uh-huh. I just figured Annie would be relatable because she was an orphan and she ain't had no father.
Fuck Jay-Z.
Of course, you started with the ether, okay. That's a good round. That's a good first round.
I mean, I just wanted to start out with the joint, you know what I mean?
Turn my music high. Fuck Jay-Z.
Wait, you already played that? Wait.
No, they playing the right songs. This is all we playing right here.
Hold on, why y'all keep playing this song?
QB.
You're supposed to play different songs every round.
Fuck Jay-Z.
Nah, I love this part right here. We gotta play this part.
Fuck Jay-Z.
Okay, we get the point that... Okay, stop saying fuck Jay-Z, okay?
Nah, you said it. Can't nobody stand...
Amanda, welcome to the Coopsters, man. Did you become a member and I didn't pay no attention? I ain't getting no notification or nothing. Thank you so much for becoming a member with us. I see that your name is green, so you must be a member. Thank you for joining. I appreciate that. Yeah, it is hilarious. It's not crazy.
Ain't on stage with you. I'm just playing my song. You know, I sampled Tupac to say fuck Jay-Z, right?
Fuck Jay-Z.
Are they playing the right song?
No, but I'm streaming it on Tidal.
A what? Why you ain't say that in the beginning? Run it back. Play it again. Play it one more time. Play it seven more times. Just run them streams up.
Fuck Jay-Z.
Heck no. Let me see if there's something right here that we can do. Oh, man. Oh, let's do this right here. Let me see what this is about.
Could you?
Of course, TC. That joint was hilarious. That's different, too. So if y'all got anything funny that y'all want to see, feel free to post it in the chat.
I knew you was going to be sitting there looking stupid. That's why I clicked on it. I said, let me hit Afion, because I know he probably sitting on the couch looking stupid, eating Kraft macaroni and cheese. What are you doing, Afion?
I'm eating asparagus, yams, and some steak bites.
There you go. Steak bites. Steak bites is what you eat. Steak bites. It's not a steak. Steak bites.
From the sound of your conversation, you eating steak bites with your dirty ass hands. Your shitty hands.
Hey, at least I'm honest about it.
I commend you.
At least I'm honest about it.
I mean, be a man.
So you were a avid hand washer? Is that what you're telling me?
I'm an OCD with my hand washing.
Like now, if I see before you, this?
No, before this. Like every time I saw you, especially, like if I ever shook your hand, I made sure that I washed my hands 1,000 fucking times.
Wait a minute, what the fuck does that mean?
Because you look like a piece of shit.
What? Hey man, I can hear you. Avion.
Boy, yo, I thought I was thinking that.
Yeah, I'm like, wait, Avion, it's Sunday.
It's Mother's Day. Because you know I always have this like I have negative thoughts about you here and your height and your smell.
You know what?
But when I speak to you, it's not supposed to come out like that. So
you know what, let's take the moment to be honest.
Okay.
I've hated the structure of your nose and eyes for years. I have never liked the alignment that your eyes and nose have. It's like a fucking beak. It's just a beak that can see. That's how I felt about you all this time. So I'm glad that now you get to go and say how you feel, because that's how I felt about you. I said, I don't want to talk to you up close because I'm afraid that I might get pecked, you fucking seagull. That's how I felt about you. So there, cats out the bag.
Well, since we're taking the moment, since the table is open.
Yeah, I mean, it's just be honest.
I just wanted to say to you, as a brother, as a fan, as a friend, as a colleague.
Yeah, that's all it is.
Your face has always looked like a 10-speed bicycle seat.
Wait, what?
I've always hated it.
What?
It looked like people with spandex sit their ass on your face and ride for miles.
What are you talking about?
The shape of your face, as you lean back like that, right?
Oh my god! No, I haven't seen it, TC. We can watch that next.
Right there. Your face looks like a bicycle seat.
Right here. You take.
You lean it back.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Your bitch ass weak man chin.
Yeah.
It looks like the pointy part of a 10-speed
I get it.
Bicycle seat.
I got it. All right, and listen. And that's just
how I feel about your face.
Yeah, it's just look, since we are we speaking candid? Are we speaking candid? Because if we're speaking
wide
candid,
open like that.
Yeah, this is just us talking as friends, right? As
brothers.
Nobody else. Yeah. You have a white woman's neck. Yeah. I think your neck is exactly like a white woman's. That's right there. That the structure of it.
I've been told that elongation in my neck.
Yeah. All of that screams white woman to me. So for all these years, you've been a black man walking around with a white woman's neck. So I don't know how that makes you feel, but I know what I see.
Happening. I'm cool with
that's
who
fine.
I am.
That's fine.
My voice goes up when I talk sometimes. On that's just regular.
Yeah.
I'm not being defensive.
Whatever, man.
I'm not being defensive.
No. Don't be.
Yo. Because I'm in my falsetto don't mean I'm being defensive. Nigga.
No, it's not. Don't get defensive. This is just us talking as brothers.
I have one more thing I need to say to you. Because I don't know when I'll see you in person again.
Thank you so much, TC. Y'all make sure y'all show TC some love in the chat right now. Make sure y'all show TC some love in the chat right now.
On the shit that we're in.
Yeah. This is just us talking candidly as friends. That's all.
Candidly as homies.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, as homies. You my guy. I'm your guy. I get it.
$100,000.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
When we both have $5 in our pocket, right?
Yeah.
I've always felt from the day I first met you that you smell exactly like mini bike smoke.
What is going on?
You smell just like the exhaust from a mini bike. You know how Meek Mill and them? You know that smell when Meek Mill and the Philly dudes be wheeling down the.
What are you talking about?
You smell like the exhaust of a really shitty minibike that used really cheap gas in it, and it's spewing out really black smoke.
What are you talking about?
You smell like minibike smoke mixed with turpentine, and I always wanted to say that to your face.
All right, well, I get it, and you know, unfortunately, you gotta hear these things to understand where you are, how you live. Just before I let you go, because I'm not, you know, I'm about to hop off, man. It's Mother's Day, so I feel
right. But you gotta spend time with your queen. Yeah, happy Mother's Day.
But before I go,
you have tears in your eyes?
Yeah, I got tears in my eyes. But before I go, I want to tell you that you have the same mouth as a piranha. So I'm not sure if you've ever seen a piranha. But the reason why they're able to get so many bites is because of the
sweating, you bitch.
Is because of the triangular shape that their mouth is able to make. And you can do the same. You can do the same thing, which allows you to eat your steak bite in rapid time. You can eat that steak bite very fast. So that's more of a congratulations, I guess.
I mean, and I appreciate that, brother.
Yeah, thank you.
That acknowledgement is something that I've always waited for.
Yeah, life. My brother.
And what I'll leave with.
Yeah. Oh, you got something else.
When the Navy SEALs discovered they had a weakness in hand-to-hand combat,
And we got caught with the ad. That's not TC's request. That's something I just found as a placer. Real quick, we watch some TC's next.
Leave you with.
Okay, go ahead. You got something else. Yeah, go ahead.
I do. I know that you work out a lot and fitness is your lifestyle and you
have, thank you,
you
man.
Have products, you have thanks brands.
Thanks for knowing. Yeah.
You have Tommy John draws. Like, you have a lot of things that you
thank you.
You know, your own Nike shoe and
thank you.
But I
thank
always you. Wanted to tell you that you work out every day, 9 hours a day. Yet your body is still shaped with my remote control. This is actual size. Actually,
he said, my body is shaped like a remote control. Okay, yeah.
This is actual size.
Yeah.
Like, when I see you, this is how I give you dap. I think,
hey, yeah.
What's up, man? I ain't sleep for a long time, bro.
Yeah, yeah.
I pick you up, and your head is wide at the top.
Yeah. Wait, give me dap
this
again.
This is what you look like.
How do you give me dap again?
I just pick you up. I pick you up like this. I say, yo. I'd be like, yo, Kev, man.
Right. Got it.
Yo, you good?
Mm-hmm.
Like, congrats on your success, man. My
yeah. Name. Got it.
Are you sweating? On your,
oh,
under
my God.
Your eyelids?
I got real tears. I'm gonna tell you what did it.
Hey, look, I just seen. Hold on, I just seen Shaq in here trying to go.
Shaq, oh my God!
Shaq in here trying to go. He trying to add his commentary.
Okay, I'm a fucking add Shaq's under.
Yeah, roast that nigga.
Afion, brother, I love you. Thank you, man. You really just made my day, man. The mini bike smoke, the mini bike exhaust. Hey, go ahead.
You smell like Philly Street. All right,
love you, man.
They silly. Kevin Hart is a fool for real, man. Let's see here.
I'm afraid to get married, man. Why wouldn't it?
Hold on, y'all. What is going on, everyone? We're about to get into Bill Burr, epidemic of gold digging. Let's check it out.
I'm afraid to get married, man. Why man wouldn't be afraid to get married at this point? You know, look at Kobe. Look at the shit he's going through right now. All right? Guy's getting a divorce. His wife's going to get $70 million. Never hit a layup in her life. You know, can anybody explain These divorce settlements, can anybody make sense of these fucking things? Tiger Woods' wife, $250 million. She's a babysitter worth a quarter of a billion fucking dollars.
Yo, make sure y'all put hearts in the chat and everything for TC.
Somebody, go ahead. Somebody, explain, justify it. Justify it. What, he cheated on her? I don't give a fuck. Yeah, I don't give a fuck. He cheated on her. Great, the relationship's over right then. Kobe cheated, right? Shouldn't that relationship been over right then? Why did she hang around like some jaded cop for 3 years trying to get her fucking pension? Right, get that 10 years in? I don't know, maybe that's too harsh. That shit bothers me, man. Dude, there is an epidemic of gold-digging whores in this country. And every night I put on the news, and I'm waiting for someone to address it. Every night, never see it, you know? And every night I bring up gold-digging whores, and the whole crowd pulls back like I'm up here talking about Bigfoot, right? Like I'm saying the moon's made out of cheese or something. Talking about whores, people. They're everywhere. How many? How many more great men are going to get chopped in half before we do something? Why is it so quiet in here? God damn, I don't get it. What is it? Is it women? Do you think I'm calling you? I'm not calling any woman here a whore, okay? So don't pull back. That's not fair, okay? If you brought up wife beaters, I wouldn't like pull back. I get it. There's guys hitting women, they need to be stopped. We gotta understand that gold-digging whores are the wife beaters for men. Yeah, they are. Except we don't have that Rihanna lumped up photo in the end, so it's not obvious. It's in the eyes. It's in the lines in your face. It's in Mel Gibson's high-pitched voice on the answering machine. I had to give up my Laker tickets, right? That is the sound of a man being taken for everything he's got. I gotta tell you, I'm envious of women.
Not the Laker tickets, though. Bruh, speaking of, what do y'all think about this Kanye and Kim situation? The latest thing I've seen is that Kanye is going to actually go get help.
Okay. I'm not saying your problems get solved, but at least they're taken seriously. You know? People, you got 1-800 numbers, you got ribbons, there's groups. People give a shit. Anything happens to a guy, it's just considered funny. Some woman cut her husband's dick off, threw in the garbage disposal, turned it on. People thought it was hilarious. They were like, hey, Stumpy, nobody cares. You think if a guy removed a woman's titty and threw it in the dryer, anybody would be joking about it the next day? The entire country would grind to a halt. There'd be a moment of silence.
Both of those are equally just sick, honestly, both of those descriptions.
The NFL would have some special colored headband everybody had to wear for an entire month. The most effeminate color they could possibly come up with. All my heroes are going down. Arnold Schwarzenegger, another great man. Taken down by that gold-digging whore of a maid he's got. And I'm not saying he's not a piece of shit for doing what he did. It was a piece of shit move. But how come only he got chastised?
Wait, what did he do? What did Arnold Schwarzenegger do?
What about the maid? Why was she called the maid that entire story? She was never called a whore, ever. Just boggled my mind. She knew his wife, first name basis, played with their kids, fucked her husband in their own goddamn bed. Mm. That's right down the checklist. First ballot Hall of Fame whore, right there. Never. Why do you think she hooked up with him? Because of that 1987 flat top he's still rocking? The giant space between his teeth I could put this mic cord through?
What do they... TC, you are, that's a very proper way of saying he got his maid pregnant. He impregnated his maid, okay.
Maybe it's all that kindergarten cop money laying around the goddamn bedroom. No, it's awful. It's a horrific thing to see as a guy, watching guys go through that shit, you know? And then there's no sort of examination of it. They just go, he's an idiot. Hey, he's stupid. That guy's stupid. If that guy's stupid, what the fuck am I, right? Does it even make sense? Why would you do that? Why would you accomplish all that and then fuck it up? Hooking up with one of the ugliest human beings I've ever seen in my life. Not saying I'm a prize, I'm just saying, you know? It's gotta be something beyond that, right? You know what I think it is? I think it comes down to the way he talks, you know? That dude should be unloading trucks in Transylvania. That should have been the height of his success. But because he's a great man, he had the balls to move to America. Became famous for lifting weights. I lift weights, nobody gives a shit. He lifts weights, becomes super famous. Did he rest on his laurels? No, next challenge. I'm gonna become an actor despite the fact that nobody can really understand me. Against all odds, he starts making movies. Get down, there's a bomb, get out of there. Becomes one of the biggest blockbuster stars of all time.
Oh my gosh, she's like, that man was extremely popular, and not once did I ever care. Just being completely transparent.
What are you gonna do next, Arnie? I think I'm Maddie or Kennedy. There's no fucking way you can do that. Bam, he does it. Cherry on top, I'm running for governor of a state I can't even pronounce, and he wins the election. Why wouldn't this guy think he couldn't bang his maid in his own bed and get away with it? This dude has been in the zone for over 4 decades.
Right.
Mm-hmm. 4 decades, nothing but net.
That's when the ego get the best of you right there.
Bang a maid in my own bed? Dude, that's a layup. Are you serious? I had a hit movie with the midget. I don't even need a condom. Right?
Sheesh.
And then what happens? The smoke clears. Then all these trolls come out of the woodwork and start judging this great man. All these...
A very strange day is coming to America. In short, a massive and surprising new transition could soon...
These fatties, these fucking old guys who never got any with their jowls coming on TV. Absolutely reprehensible behavior. What kind of a public servant? His legacy is shattered. Like they have any idea what it's like to be tempted at that level, right? Like they have groupies as they waddle out to their Mercury tracer parked on the other side of a dumpster. Really? You're beating them off? This guy, he's not a great man anymore. Terminator doesn't count. Is that what the fuck you're telling me? Because he fucked Alice? Really? He's still not a great man because he did that. Then that's the whole thing's over. Anybody here think they could move to Austria, learn the language, become famous for working out, then be a movie star, then marry into their royalty and hold public office? How many lifetimes would you need? I'm on my third attempt at Rosetta Stone Spanish. Right? How can I judge?
Third, though. Listen, that Rosetta Stone sounds like a blessing, but it's a curse at the same time. Like, who got the patience? Shout out to the people who do.
These guys. I can barely handle the temptations of Facebook. I'm gonna judge Tiger Woods. I golf, I don't walk off the 18th hole and there's a busload of Scandinavian women waiting to fuck my brains out. Sorry, ladies, gotta go home to the wife, right? No, it kills me. And there's no help out there for guys. There isn't. There's nothing out there to help you handle becoming rich and famous. There's nothing to prepare you for that platoon of whores that's going to form on the horizon.
The only thing that's waiting is people with their hand out.
Horizon, right? Like Braveheart, faces painted, skirts on, will run down the hill, they'll jump on your dick in front of your wife. They don't give a shit. It's not even a handbook out there. I saw one article written about it on the cover of Time magazine. It said, why do so many rich, famous, and powerful men act like absolute pigs, right? And the article was actually written by a woman.
Mm.
That's like me writing a book, The Third Trimester, and What to Expect. Ladies, you're gonna feel a pressure.
He got a point.
How the hell would I know? You don't wanna hear that from me, right? Then why is this woman telling me what it's like to have a dick? That makes no sense. You have no idea what it's like to have a dick. 24/7. Do it, do it. Fuck it, do it. That's what it's saying. Do it, do it. Yeah, do it. That's how we survived as a species. Every man in here is programmed to fuck 85% of the women in this room. Right? Yeah, we are. Do it, fuck it, do it, you know? It's just that you won't. That's the only reason why we don't, you know? That's not you keeping your dick in check, you know? Some guy at Home Depot working there, he wants to fuck just as many women as a celebrity, right? But he can't do it because whores don't care about lumber, right? But the second he hits the fucking lottery, all of a sudden, you know, that do it, fucking do it, you know? That wasn't affecting his life. Then all of a sudden these whores show up. I'll do it. I'll suck it. I'll do it, right? No, somebody's got to step up, all right? I'm not even blaming whores, really. Guys, we're fucking idiots. What are we doing? Why are we working so hard and then giving it all away to some chick who did three shifts at a fucking Hooters, you know? They're fucking bums sitting there with fucking Dorito dust in their cleavage, walking around with hundreds of millions of dollars. I'm sick of that shit. That's what the law says. 100 years ago, I could beat you with a fucking mop handle and be like, well, that's what the law says. Doesn't make us right.
Man, wow. What's going on, Doppel? Yeah, it's funny videos today.
No, it's unreal. And all this shit's going down, and we're not doing anything. What are we doing? Same old shit. Sitting around watching Shark Week, right? Watching shit about poisonous snakes half a world away, just filling your head up with all this useless information. What to do if you come face to face with a Bengal tiger? Don't look at it. Don't look away. Slowly back up as you push your friend forward, right? All this useless information, yet hanging between your legs is this thing that could crumble your entire empire 7 minutes or less. Don't know a fucking thing about it. Even worse, you think it's your friend. Yeah, you know why? Because your dick's like a dreamer, you know? Your dick believes. It's like a motivational speaker. I don't give a shit what question you ask it. It's always like, yeah, absolutely. Sounds like a plan. Exit strategy. Later. We'll be fine. Where's your dick when you get caught, right? Then it's just slumped over like, hey, I thought it was a good idea, you know? Yeah. You have to know that. Dude, if your dick was a third base coach, it wouldn't hold anybody up. It'd just be fucking waving people around. Everybody, go in standing up. You got it. You got it. Oh, shit, here she comes. Slide. All right, you guys were awesome. Thank you so much for coming out. I hope you had...
Man, that was a crazy stand-up right there by Bill Burr. I am your girl, V-Coop. Down peace in the V-Coop to be exact. Make sure you like, comment, share, subscribe, all that good stuff, man. Come over to the COOP Troop Live, too, every single day, 2:30 to 4:30 p.m. Eastern Time Zone. Make sure you check out the video that's popping up on your screen right now and the rest of my Bill Burr reactions, all right? Till next time, thank you for joining. All right, beautiful people. Let me see. Told, I'm guessing what you put is, yep. I'm guessing this supposed to be funny. Of course, TC, thank you for sharing. It ain't but a minute, 35 seconds. Hold on, y'all see them holding Elmo right there, though? Ain't nobody just about to have a trap song with Elmo in their hands and holding the gun at the same time. This is hurting my ears, and dang, it's a whole nother minute left. to his jaw. Toe, what happened to his jaw? I know, TC, they got you just coming in by yourself. Oof, I can't do it. I thought I could. I only had a few seconds left, too. That y'all hurt my ear, and I don't even know what he's saying. The first few seconds was funny, though. I'm gonna do another Chappelle Show reaction.
Let's see.
Excuse me. Did I not do this one already? I'll wait, do that a different time. Okay, this looks like it's gonna be hilarious.
My name's Jeff. I'm a computer programmer.
What is going on, everyone? We are about to get into Joe Rogan meets Tyrone Biggums on Fear Factor. Let's check this out. I ain't seen Fear Factor in years. Did y'all watch Fear Factor?
My name's Jeff. I'm a computer programmer from Redondo Beach, and I refuse to lose.
My name's Rita. I'm from Idaho, but trust me, I ain't no couch potato.
I'm Anne. I'm from Boston. I promised my mom I wasn't going to embarrass her here tonight.
Oh! I'm Tyrone Biggums. I heard that I can win a lot of money and I get a pig testicle dinner with all the fixings. You gotta play to win.
Here is your first stunt.
We gotta eat that? I can't eat all of it.
You each have to lie in this coffin covered with worms and bugs. The three of you that can last the longest will move on to the next round. Rita, you're up first. Climb on in. All right, we're gonna have to add a few more to the mix.
Oh, God. Oh, Joe Rogan, you crazy.
God, one of them tried to crawl in my mouth. Oh,
God. 1 minute and 42 seconds.
Let me just help you out. Get some on this. There you go. Look at them spreading. They spreading.
5 minutes and 42 seconds. Anne, it's all up to you. Lie down.
Oh, God, that was gross.
Wow. All right, Ty.
I'm gonna tell you something about me, Joe Rogan, that you might not know. I smoke rocks.
What the world? I got you, Doppel, after this.
You did it, Tyrone. You shattered Jeff's time. You can come on out now.
Joe Rogan, if it's all the same to you, I'd like to finish reading my newspaper. I haven't had a chance to sit still and read for so long.
Technically, you can stay in there as long as you want.
You know what? I think I'm gonna take a nap. Could you dim the lights, please, Joe Rogan? Oh. Crack.
All right, it's time for your next challenge.
This man is crazy. Oh my gosh.
Challenge. Walking on hot coals. Some of these coals burn.
You peep, he still got the worms in his head.
Burn at over 1,000 degrees.
God damn.
The two people that can spend the most time on those coals will advance. All right, Rita, you're up first. Ready to do this?
Yeah.
Go! Time! 8 seconds. Go!
This
come on, Jeff. Time! 7 seconds. Vita, he didn't beat your time. Congratulations, you advance automatically. Tyrone, it's up to you now. All you have to do is beat Jeff's time of 7 seconds, and you will move on to the next round and be that much closer to $50,000.
Oh!
Take your shoes off. Let's do it.
Whoa.
Tyrone, I think it's something wrong with your feet.
Oh!
Go.
Hey, Joe Rogan, is it almost lunchtime? Because I smell somebody cooking.
You.
Cajun steaks.
You cooking, and you smelling everything you done walked on.
Catfish, fried peppers. Mmm.
Tyrone, are you okay?
Huh?
You won. You beat Jeff's time. You advance the next round.
My feet are strong.
Oh.
Hmm.
All right, Rita, Tyrone, here is your final stunt. Each one of these platters.
I mean, on the upside, he ain't gotta ask nobody for a lighter.
Contains over 3 pounds of elk penis and a light cream testicle sauce. It's topped off with diced pig bladder. For dessert, we have horse hooves. Whoever can eat the most is gonna walk away with $50,000. Go!
Dang, you right. Let me turn it up just a little bit. My fault. Dang, but I can't. The only reason why I can't is because it'll block my video. So that's why it's like that. I'm sorry, y'all.
Hurry up, girl. I'm gonna do my turn. Grab that penis. Suck them juices off. Suck it. That's it.
I can't do this.
Are you sure? All right, I'm sorry. You're eliminated. All right, Ty, it's up to you. All you have to do is eat a little bit, and you're the
and
champion.
Yada, yada, yada. You know, Joe Rogan, this is not the first time I've tasted penis. I've had several in my line of work. You taste penises all the time. Cocaine is a health drug.
Tyrone, you...
say in my line of work, though.
You are our champion. Congratulations.
Oh!
And evidently, fear is not a factor for you.
Fear is never a factor, Joe Rogan. I'm trying to get some crack rocks. Carita, I did it. I won. Come down on these penises with me. Hot sauce. There you go. Pretend like it's mine. Carita. This money's gonna change our lives forever.
Oh my God.
Carita, I can finally make an honest woman out of you. Give you that rock. You always had your eye on. Yes, Carita.
Tyrone, this will get us high for
hours. I know. But first, may I have this dance?
What in the entire world? I am your girl V Coop, down piece in the V Coop to be exact. Make sure you like, comment, share, subscribe, all that good stuff, man. Come over to the Coop Troop Live 2 every single day, 2:30 to 4:30 p.m. Eastern time zone. All right. Also check out the video that's popping up on your screen right now, as well as the other Chappelle Show reactions. Also, if you're ever feeling generous, check out the information right above my head over there somewhere. And donate. Donos are accepted, not requested. All right. Till next time, thank you for joining. All right, let's check out yours, Doppel. Let me see.
Instagram can help your business connect with people who make your Instagram content more actionable by
I don't know if it's because it's how bright it is in here. Let me see something real quick. I'm going to try to change something. Oh, yeah, it should be fine. It's supposed to be funny, right? Long as it's in the realm to make us laugh, it should be fine. I don't know why that one looks super. Let me see something here. Properties. Oh, that's not the one. Hold on, y'all. I'm trying to figure this out. How do I don't even know how to reset. Try to redo this. Okay, so I think that was one of the problems is however it was the first time. I probably should have been reset it. So this should be a little bit better than it was. Is it Spinal Tap? These go to 11. It's 49 seconds. Yeah, it says Spinal Tap. Should be it.
This is a top to you know, what we use on stage, but it's very, very special because if you can see, the numbers all go to 11. Look, right across the board. 11,
and amps go up to 10.
Exactly.
Does that mean it's louder? Is it any louder?
Well, it's one louder, isn't it? It's not 10. You see, most blokes are going to be playing at 10. You're on 10 here, all the way up, all the way up, all the way up. You're on 10 on your guitar. Where can you go from there? Where?
I don't know.
Nowhere, exactly. What we do is if we need that extra push over the cliff, you know what we do?
Put it up to 11.
11, exactly. One louder.
Why don't you just make 10 louder and make 10 be the top number and make that a little louder?
These go to 11.
Exactly, TC. That's all crazy. Okay. Alright, we're about to check out the imitator.
Cancun starts October 29th. Just go to alaskaair.com.
Alright, so we're getting some requests. Apparently, Harry Spears, who was here and who was at Cobb's all this weekend, does a really mean like DMX and Jay-Z. Which one are we going to hear?
I might give you a medley of...
A medley?
A medley.
All right, it's a little freestyle action. Here we go. Ready?
Yep.
Harry Spears.
Yo, what's up, It's your man, LL Cool J. We're going to do it sexy right now, baby. Know what I mean? Got my man Snoop Dogg, DMX, and Jay-Z in the building. Hey, yo, Snoop, holla at him, you know what I mean? It's LL.
Hey, yo, Snoop, D, yo, double jizzle. I'm in the hissy nizzle. And when you see me, you gon' still get that middle finger. As I linger on that liquor, that chronic, that blue chronic, that tonic, that eating JJ. Snoop Dogg, that's how I get down. Come around. Snoop, DMX, show him how we get down.
It's your man DMX. Where my dogs at? Told you fools, when a dog's in the streets, you don't want to see that beast. When that dog's off the leash, I might show you the teeth, then I'ma give you the spark. If I can get you in the day, what? I'll get you in the dark, yeah. Shamir, DMX, I'm hard. How I bust 100 guns? Jay-Z, on the mic, it's next. Shamir, DMX. It's your boy Young, Hobie, the Jay-Z, the game is real. I told y'all I've been through the fourth meal. It's Young Hobie, I'm on a different plane, different name. I'm with the chick with the French frames and the French name. I'm like Young Hobie, yo, Jay-Z is better. Guaranteed when you see me, I'll put four through your sweater. It's your boy Young Hobie, Young Age God, legendary. It's your boy Young in the building. It's your boy, you know how we do. Jay in the building, man. You know what I mean? Brooklyn, stand up. It's your boy Young Hobie. Hope, yo, I'm back for another verse. Better get another curse. And I'ma spit one that's even worse than the first you heard when I spit it. My game's all less spitted. And when you see me, hope, never bit it. I do it from the head, I do it from the heart. Guaranteed I bust real. Y'all cats very smart. It's your boy Young Hope Young. There it is.
Oh man.
That's crazy. I've always liked individuals who can make their voice like many different people. The Jay-Z laugh at the end of it. Yeah. That was crazy. I mean, it was perfect. Each person was perfect. Now we're going to get into some Key and Peele. I probably should put Key and Peele show. I wonder, should I get these at the beginning instead of trying to get the old ones? I'll check this one out. Bet, Robert.
You wish to be a crime reporter in Japan.
I got you, Robert. I'm gonna do this one first. I appreciate y'all for being on here with me. Truly do. All right, y'all. We are about to get into Key and Peele insult comic. Let's check it out.
Thank you, sir.
All right. All right. How's everybody doing? All right. And you guys can all hear me okay?
Yeah.
All right. I know this guy can right here. Boy, this guy's ears are so big, he's laughing at jokes from the Yuck Yuck Club all the way on the other side of town. All right. And you, sir, you're doing okay?
Right.
And you're getting enough to eat? Oh, is that even possible? Thank you, sir. Folks, I'm sorry. I'm going to get everybody tonight. Nobody is safe. I'm getting everybody, except for you, sir. I'm going to leave you alone. Just like your date did tonight. Hello! All right. Okay, who is next? Who is next?
He's trying not to say nothing, but he gonna say something
hey,
anyway.
Hey, ma'am. I get it. You have breasts, okay? Jeez, I mean, look at this chick over here. Her cleavage is giving the
Greg... Hold on. Wait, is it because he wanna be clowned on and he not gonna do it?
Canyon an inferiority complex.
You skipped me.
Who's talking right now?
Do me.
Yeah, hey man. Look at that pink shirt you got on there. Wow. Where'd you get that? queert-shirts.com.
It's in support of breast cancer awareness. I am gay, though.
Okay.
Go for it. I can take it.
Oh, yeah, yeah. No, hey, yeah, don't you worry about that, man. Gloves are coming off. Okay. Right there, right there. What's with the three drinks, man? Alcoholic much?
This is my pain medication.
Of course it is. It's your pain medication. Because he is in pain. Right now.
Make fun of the burns.
Make fun of the, what did you say? Because here's the problem, sir, is it's really dark in here, and sorry, are you burned? Because I can't make it out. Thanks so much, ma'am, for illuminating me. Thank you. I appreciate that. Oh, those burns.
Make fun of the robot voice.
Sir, I don't know.
Come on, I can take it.
Okay, well, no, you know what? I feel
or the wheelchair.
Look, sir, there is nothing funny about you being in a wheelchair, and we can all...
but there is something funny about me being fat.
All right, no, all right, fine, fine. I've got it. I'm doing it. I just didn't want to go after this guy because I didn't want him to kill me in my dreams. Like Freddy Krueger. Because No? Did you see how Freddy Krueger's face is burned off? That's not...
Which is exactly why he didn't do it.
You ass.
He said he could take it. That's what he said.
I thought I could, but I can't.
How's this on me? How do we even know if he's crying right now? Well, I don't know that sound. It just sounds like an electronic sound.
Are
we?
The tears. They burn.
He said he could take it. Yeah.
What is this?
Did you throw that bottle, Donald?
I think this is just a little ad or something.
Spread the meat.
You fools!
Lathering away!
Dicks are hilarious, though!
No good. Did any of that actually get in your mouth?
No!
Oh my gosh, I am your girl V-Coop, down piece in the V-Coop to be exact. Make sure you like, comment, share, subscribe, all that good stuff, man. Come over to the COOP Troop Live every single day, 2:30 to 4:30 p.m. Eastern Time Zone. Check out the video that's popping up on your screen right now, all right, as well as the other Key and Peele reactions, all right? Till next time, thank you for joining. All right, y'all, about to get into the drive-through skeleton prank. I actually got to pee, y'all.
For this video, I'm gonna make the skeleton go through some drive-thrus.
Wow, that's dope.
What the f?
What?
Nuggets.
Oh, you want some sauce?
Yes.
Screaming all that time and still come all the way up to the window crying.
He's on the internet.
What the hell? Tony! Tony! Let me give you $100 bill, man.
Hey, man.
I'm being serious, too.
Okay, love you, man.
Yeah, I love you, too, man.
I think that's dope. I think that's dope. I love clever minds like that. Alright, y'all, TC, I'm about to get into yours. Yeah, I definitely would love to watch more of those. We could keep doing those.
Red Bull give.
Do you think any of us will look back in our lives and regret the thing?
Robert, I'll save them for a day like today, for Fridays. Just thinking, I wanted to know how the little girl left.
Meu Deus.
casa não abre. Gente, abre, eu tenho medo, por favor. Eu sou medrosa, não gosto assim. Por favor. Gente,
for real.
Pode ir, fica à vontade, tá? Pode apertar, sétimo andar. Até mais.
Thank you so much, TC. Make sure y'all put some angels in the comments for TC right now. Also, how do y'all think they get these people inside of the elevator? Like, where does that come from?
Acompanhar? Pode ir, tá?
Exactly, Doppel. I also thought about what if they peed on themselves, like all kinds of crazy stuff.
Aqui, ó, pode apertar aqui no sétimo andar, por favor. Boa sorte. Até já. Folks know they foul. Talk. Have y'all ever seen those Spanish movies and like how dramatic they are? Like, that's the first impression that I got from him. Thank you. Small business owners know. Oh my gosh, I got tears in my eyes. Oh my gosh, I know that man peed on himself, TC. What the world? Wow. That was a great way to end, though, the way that she ran after him. Oh my gosh. That was the first time since we've been on here that tears been in my eyes. Literally. I think it's funny too because I'm claustrophobic, so that would really freak me out. I don't like when people jump on elevators, none of that. Sleepy. I ain't really sleepy. I took a nap. I'm just, I guess I'm still waking up type deal. Yeah, that was hilarious. Keep them coming. Keep them coming. All right, y'all. We are about to get into ISMO. Hopefully that's correct. ASS is the most complicated word in the English language. Wow. Let's see what he say.
My next guest is the first comedian from Finland to perform on American television. This is a first. He can be seen live
from Finland, huh?
This weekend and at the Improv in Bragg, California on February 13th, making his late night stand-up debut with us this evening. Please welcome the very funny Ismo.
Hello. Hello. Good evening. I am Ismo, and yes, I am from Finland.
Ismo, yeah, okay.
I moved to America about a year ago, and it's been great. But I have to say that it took a long time to learn the things, like the small, subtle things. Like, it took me a year to figure out that the correct answer to what's up is what's up. It took a long time, but now I know. If somebody says, what's up, I just say, what's up. it feels wrong. Like, I feel I'm not answering a question. But they are happy. So I just keep doing it. And it took me even longer than that to finally learn that can I help you actually means go away. I'm always learning, but I think the language still has been the most difficult part, because I studied English for years and I thought I know English, but then I moved to America, turns out no. Like, I didn't really know it, like all the things. Like, I think the hardest word to truly master has been the word ass. I thought it's really easy. It means a butt. But no. like yes, sometimes it can mean a butt, but that's just the tip of the iceberg. Like, there are so many meanings to the word ass. I think it's the most complicated word in English. I've been trying to write a whole dictionary about just ass.
Yeah, I think he's super funny, and it's also relatable, because when I was in Europe, the reason why he said what he said about what's up is because in Europe, you can ask people how they doing, they'll really tell you how they doing. But out here, we not really like that.
There's so many. Like, for example, lazy ass. That means lazy. Like my lazy ass husband, it's the same sentence without the ass. The ass is just optional there. It's and long ass means long. Like a long ass flight. But if you want to make it longer, you can add ass. And my definite favorite one, a grown ass man. It turns out it means a grown man.
Yes.
The entire man has grown. Not only his ass. So I learned that you can just add ass to anything. And then it sounds a little bit cooler. Like anything. I just bought this blue ass shirt. Oh, thank you. That was some good ass meatballs. Anything. But you have to be careful, because sometimes if you add ass to something, it can actually reverse the meaning of the original word. Like, for example, bad ass. That's good. Like, bad is bad, but bad ass is good. But not always. Like, dumb ass is still dumb. So how can you know? You have to know specifically which ones are flipped. And then there's the concept of your ass. And your ass, that means like yourself. Like move your ass. That's like move everything. Like move your ass and the rest of your body. And like everything. If you have a car, that's included in the ass. All of them, same direction, just move. So your ass means yourself plus all you have. But my ass, that means like no. Like, if I say that, wow, this car is really fast, and you say, oh, fast, my ass. So, it means like, no. It's not fast. And to make it even more complicated, ass can be divided. Like, because if you are an ass, that means that you're being stupid. But if you're half-ass... Then it means that you are not concentrating properly. And if you go even smaller, if you are a piece of ass, then you are beautiful.
It's called Ishmo A *** is the most complicated word in the English language.
Thanks a lot.
Dang, that's the end of it right there. What a hilarious stand-up comedy. That was really good. Thank you, Doppel. I am your girl, V-Coop. Dime piece in the V-Coop to be exact. Make sure you like, comment, share, subscribe. All that good stuff, man. Come over to the COOP Troop Live every single day. 2:30 to 4:30 p.m. Eastern time zone, all right? Check out the video that's popping up on your screen right now, as well as my other comedian reactions, all right? Or comedy reactions. Till next time, thank you for joining. Yeah, y'all some fools for that one. Whew. This is getting better and better. We getting better and better with our Fridays, because this was completely fun. Maybe not fun, but funny. See. First black cookout.
All right, I'm gonna start this one off by saying I got. A lot of black friends, okay? Most of them I got through playing football. They were my teammates. We've been to war together on the football field, loving to death. Now, with that being said, ever since I have had said friends, they have told me that I have a bad habit of putting them in white people positions. I do not fully understand what they mean, but they gave me the reference of like, passing a cop on a two-lane road because he's going underneath the speed limit. Apparently, they ain't supposed to do that. It makes them nervous. Anyway, about a week ago, get a call from a buddy of mine. Play football together. Says, hey, buddy, I want you to come to a cookout. Hell, you ain't got to hit me in the face with a wet mop. I like cookouts. So I show up to the cookout.
What's goody, Prince Jay? How you feeling?
Yeah. All right. As I step out of my pick-em-up truck, I realized that the only three white things at this cookout is the salt shaker, the napkins, and me. Alright. As I'm walking up, I am being greeted by his grandma and grandpa, and his great-grandma and grandpa, and his 47 cousins. Alright, which there's 47. No way for me to remember all these people's names. Anyway, there's a long table where the food's, where the food, everybody's eating at. Okay? They bring me over and set me down at the head of the table.
Not the head.
I'm already really uncomfortable at this point, because I don't know what's about to happen. Well, they say the blessing, and I get up to go fix my food. Well, I was not aware that at a black cookout, you do not fix your own plate. They fix your plate for you. Now, they bring me a whopping Dixie plate that some bitch is round.
We doing funny reactions today, so it could be parodies of songs or parodies of anything. It could be Chappelle Show, Key and Peele, any comedian stand-up. What else did we just watch? Yeah, that's pretty much what we've been doing. Pranks, it could be that as well.
It off like this.
No, no problem.
Okay? And I'm going to eat it. Don't get me wrong, I don't waste food. I'm going to eat it. So as I'm sitting there munching away, you know, just kind of getting my bearings about where I'm at, these two ladies walk up to me, two of his aunties, with two different potato salads. All right. They say, we want to get your opinion on which one of these is better.
Uh-oh. Now,
apparently just because I'm white, I'm supposed to know the different calibers of mayonnaise. Well, I ain't finna piss nobody off at this cookout, okay? So I ate both of them, and I told them that they were just so damn good, both of them, I couldn't pick one. Now, at this current time, I am almost in a food coma, because I've ate so much, because I didn't want to disrespect nobody's cooking there. And then his great-grandma, Mama T, that's what they call her, she comes up to me with what looks like a 5-pound piece of cherry pie. Now, let me paint a picture for you. I've got the meat sweats, all right? That barbecue sauce on my shirt. I'm drifting in and out of consciousness, and she's bringing me a 5-pound piece of pie. Now, I saw Friday After Next. I know what happens when you disrespect somebody's grandmama. I saw what happened to Craig and Day-Day when they disrespect somebody's grandmama. You ain't finna be chasing me through these pines, because we way out in the woods at this cookout. I'm white, not stupid. So as I eat this pie, which I'm eating this pie because I ain't finna piss off nobody, especially the head woman there, because she's ranked up top. That's great grandma. You don't mess with her. I finish this pie and I drift off into a Caucasian kykosis of a food coma.
What in the world? Caucasians kytosis, though? What?
Just like this right here. Just like this. I went, whew, I'm full. As soon as I tipped my head back up, the table I'm sitting at is no more food on this table. I don't know how long I was out for. But somehow, I'm still in the same chair. I have been dealt into a high-stakes spades game at an all-black cookout besides me. What the fuck is going on? How did I get here? At what point in my life did I take this turn to take me to where I'm at? And now the cards is in front of me, and I got no idea how to play spades, okay? None. I got no idea. All right, I'm white. We played Go Fish and Cornhole. Thanks. All we did, we got bored one day, literally did the whitest thing possible, walked out in the field, got some corn, took our pocket knives and cut it off the stalk, all right? Put it in a bag, went over there, found some plywood in the shed, cut a hole in it, put it on an angle, and we toss it at each other. That's what we do. I have no idea what spades is. So as they give me the runaround idea what the hell is going on with this spades game, I look at my hand and I realize that I probably got a pretty decent hand. Well, they asked me, they said, Zach, how many books you got? Which they had just explained this to me now. I'm talking about just now. I said, it looks like I got 8 books. Apparently, that is the wrong damn answer for your first hand of spades ever, because as soon as I said I got 8 books, 3 Glock 9s hit the top of the table. I've got every damn spade you could possibly have and 3 other aces. Well, as I survive that round, I go to get up, and one of his cousins come over and tap me on the shoulder and say, hey, buddy, you want to go throw bones? I don't know what they're talking about. I ain't got a shitting clue what they're talking about. But I ain't going to piss nobody off. You got to understand, at this point, I am in survival mode. I am not pissing not one person off at this cookout. I do whatever they tell me to do. If they want me to stand on my head and blow bubbles out of my ass, I will do it. Don't hurt me.
That man okay? said, I gotta make it home.
Now, I did not know bones meant dice. I was leaning more toward dominoes, which I kind of knew how to play from the Elks Lodge. But apparently, bones means dice. I lost $36 so fast my fucking head was spinning. Okay? And apparently when they yell gator, that just code word for white man loses, because they just took my money and I just put some more down until I ran out of money. Which is fine. Made it through that one too. Now, as I'm slowly trying to make my way back to my truck, I went over to thank Mama T. You know, I thank my buddy. I thank everybody on the way to my truck. And I've got my truck in my sights. I am zeroed in on my truck trying to leave this place. Now, I get to my truck. I put my hand on my truck to go open it, and there's a sense of relief that comes over me. Like, I didn't piss nobody off. Nothing went wrong. I went, whew, I made it. Now, as I open my door, I feel a tap on my shoulder. I turn around. The whole damn cookout is behind me. Everybody there is right around my truck, with Mama T right there in the front and my buddy. And he looked at me, he said, hey, buddy, next week's Mama T's birthday. You coming back? And I looked at him. Bamboozled on what to say. And the only thing I could come up with was, you damn right I'm coming back. Because that's the best damn barbecue I've ever had in my life. I don't know if you've ever been to All Black Cookout. But I'm going to tell you something. You get the invitation, you better take that shit. Because that is the best food you ever going to get, and the nicest damn people. I scared shitless. I ain't going to lie. I'm a big guy. I was acting like a little bitch. I didn't know what was happening. But at the same time, that's the most fun and some of the best people I've ever been around in my entire life. I'm going back next week. Bet. I told him, I said, y'all need me to bring something like some ice, because I ain't trying to cook with y'all. Y'all want some ice? Or like some, you want me to go get my little cousin Kyle to wear his monster hats and shit and bring him? You know, so he'll feel at home. He got wife beaters and stuff. What y'all need? They told me I couldn't bring nothing but myself, me, and I. Which I will be there. I'm white.
Now that was hilarious. Dang, yeah, I ain't recorded that one. I don't even know when that came out. Yeah, that was a minute ago. Ooh. Dang, funniest guy in the world. Hey, y'all, I don't see no more requests. So we gonna head on up out of here. Today, I enjoyed y'all. I enjoyed the request that y'all put in. And we leaving like, 10 minutes early, you feel me? I'm kind of happy because I want to go grub. FNCH, what's going on, BZH? How you feeling? Thank you for joining. You have just reached the end. I don't think I have anything, you know, to say. Tomorrow I should be back here. Thank you, TC. Thank you, Toad. Thank you, Doppel. Thank you, Robert. Thank you, Prince J. Thank you, FNCH. Everybody that came through for your girl, thank you. Thank you for helping me transition. Thank you, Amanda, for becoming a member. If you want to be a part of our membership, just check the description below. It should have the information there. If you don't see it, just let me know. I'll get it to you. Or matter of fact, it should be a join button underneath this video. And that's that'll have more information as well. But yeah, let's continue to grow this community. Thank y'all for sticking with me through the changes. I definitely believe that it's getting better and better. I definitely need y'all support now. When people try to slick disrespect me, I need y'all support on that. Let's continue to, you know, protect each other as well. Even though this is social media, it's still live, you understand? But yeah, other than that, I appreciate each and every one of you. Let's continue to grow. Monday, Motivation Monday. Tuesday, Trap Music Tuesday. Wednesday, Mix Wednesday with techno, pop, reggae, whatever is not rock and rap.
Thursday is Rockout Thursday. Friday is Fun Friday. So those are 5 days that's locked in. Saturday, we still kind of figuring out. Maybe I'll just do whatever y'all want to do on Saturday if I'm not doing Q&A. So yeah, I got to figure out which one I'm doing tomorrow or whatever. I appreciate you, TC. Just keep your eyes open because sometimes it can be missed. All right. But yeah, see y'all later. Till next time, enjoy your weekend.